today. I say yes, my Lord, I say yes, my Lord, to be a healer of all pain. I say yes, my Lord,
I say yes, my Lord,
to come open enemies. I say yes, my Lord,
I say yes, my Lord,
for your peace in all the world. I say yes, my Lord,
I say yes, my Lord,
I say yes, my Lord, in all the good times, through all the bad times. I say yes, my Lord, to every word you speak. Like that of Job increasingly.
Good morning. Welcome to presentation of the Blessed Virgin Mary Parish as we celebrate the 26th Sunday in Ordinary Time. If you are visiting today, we welcome you and invite you to worship with us again. Please rise as you are able and join in singing our opening song, number 849. We'll sing verses 1, 3, and 4.
All people that on earth do dwell, sing to the Lord with cheerful voice. Him serve with mirth, his praise forth tell. Come we before him and rejoice. Oh, enter then his gates with joy, his courts unto. Praise loud and bless his name always, for it is seemly so to do. For why the Lord our God is good, his mercy is forever sure.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, what a beautiful and glorious morning for us to be gathered together to give our Lord praise and thanksgiving for the many blessings that he has bestowed upon us. And so now, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever-Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest. Glory to God in the highest. To people of good will.
Let us pray. O God, who manifest your almighty power, above all by pardoning and showing mercy, bestow, we pray, your grace abundantly upon us, and make those hastening to attain your promises heirs to the treasures of heaven. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. Thus says the Lord, you say, the Lord's way is not fair. Hear now, house of Israel. Is it my way that is unfair, or rather, are not your ways unfair? When someone virtuous turns away from virtue to commit iniquity and dies, it is because of the iniquity he committed that he must die. But if he turns away from the wickedness he has committed and does what is right and just, he shall preserve his life. Since he has turned away from all the sins that he has committed, he shall surely live. He shall not die. The word of the Lord. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Brothers and sisters, if there is any encouragement in Christ, any solace in love, any participation in the Spirit, any compassion and mercy, complete my joy by being of the same mind, with the same love, united in heart, thinking of one thing. Do nothing out of selfishness or out of vainglory. Rather, humbly regard others as more important than yourselves, each looking out not for his own interests, but also for those of others. Have in mind the same attitude that is also in Christ Jesus, who, though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God something to be grasped. Rather, he emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, coming in human likeness and found in human appearance, he humbled himself, becoming obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Because of this, God greatly exalted him and bestowed on him the name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bend, of those in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue confessed that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. The word of the Lord.
Be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to the chief priests and elders of the people, "What is your opinion? A man had two sons. He came to the first and said, 'Son, go out and work in the vineyard today.' He said in reply, 'I will not,' but afterwards changed his mind and went. The man came to the other son and gave him the same order. He said in reply, 'Yes, sir,' but did not go. Which of the two did his father's will?" They answered, "The first." Jesus said to them, "Amen, I say to you, tax collectors and prostitutes are entering the kingdom of God before you. When John came to you in the way of righteousness, you did not believe him, but tax collectors and prostitutes did. Yet even when you saw that, you did not later change your minds and believe him." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you.
So last week, my dear brothers and sisters, I shared with you how in the gospel reading that our Lord presented to us in that parable about the landowner and how he kept going out to find workers for his vineyard, paid them all the same wage from the one who came at the early beginning of the day to the one who only worked 1 hour of the day, and how in that example, in that parable that our Lord gives to us, is very different from the way that we look out and live out our lives here in this world, right? Because here in this world, we get caught up in what I said is a rat race, right? We're so busy trying to become successful for ourselves that it becomes a detriment to ourselves and sometimes even to others, those closest to us, our neighbors, our colleagues, whomever. And so today, we hear a beautiful prayer, a beautiful wish from our brother St. Paul to the Philippians. And it was, and this was his wish, that all of us would be of the same mind, the same love, united in heart, and thinking of one thing, doing nothing out of selfishness or out of vainglory, rather humbly regarding others as more important than yourselves, looking out for not your own interests, but those of others. It's a beautiful thing, right? Because in the parable from last week, one of the things I forgot to mention was that, you know, when Jesus gave us that beautiful parable and shared with us how the landowner was very generous with what he had, given everyone the same payment, it was supposed to be an image of heaven, right? And so what our Lord was saying, that yes, all those who work for the kingdom of heaven will have that same reward. Heaven with the Father, with the Savior. And so here in this world, it gets a little murkier, right? Like, there's a lot of things that are at place. And so many times we can be like in that first reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel, where we say, Lord, that's not fair. Your ways aren't fair. Why is it that everyone is able to receive the same payment in heaven, but I'm doing more work, or it appears that I'm doing more work? And so our Lord responds back to the prophet by saying, is it my way that is not fair, or is it your way that is not fair? Because again, in this world, my dear brothers and sisters, we have a lot of conflicts, right? There's things that I want to do. There's people I love. But then there's also my own self-interest. And all these things become conflicted because I want so many different things, and yet I don't know what to do. And so we go back to St. Paul and his letter to the Philippians, who shared with us who Jesus Christ is. And these words are very powerful. And so I invite you to really reflect on it and listen to them. Jesus, who, though in the form of God, did not regard equality with God something to be grasped. Jesus, though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God something to be grasped. What does that mean? What does that mean? Do you know? So St. Paul, he uses beautiful words, but sometimes they're so beautiful, it's like, but I don't understand it. I get it, but I don't understand. And so what St. Paul is trying to remind us is that, yeah, who is Jesus? He's God. That's why we're here, to worship him. He's our Savior. But how is he God and yet he did not regard himself like God? What does that mean? Well, what St. Paul is trying to remind us is that God loved us so much that he was willing to become like one of us, a man. And during his time with us, he didn't use his power or his authority to oppress us as a king might, knowing that he is better than us. Rather, instead, he came like one of us and lived like one of us, never demanding more than what was expected from those around him. That's what St. Paul's talking about in that first line. Though he was God, he did not regard equality with God something to be grasped at. And rather, he emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, coming in human likeness, and found human in appearance, he humbled himself, becoming obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. God himself loved us so much that he became like us, and not even pushing his own authority on us and oppressing us, but instead wanted to serve us in his human likeness, right? In his humanity. And why would he do this? Why would God do this But unless he wanted us to see the love that he had for us. And this is important for us to understand, right? Because in his great love that he wants to pour out to us, he's also telling us at the same time, be like me. Imitate me. Imitate me as I live in this world, because you live in this world. By the life I live, I'm showing you how to live with one another. And so he's showing us how to do that by serving each other, by sacrifice, pouring out himself for you, for me, even to the point of death, death on a cross. It's mind-blowing, right? What our Lord is expecting from us. But this is why St. Paul said what he said earlier on, that he prays that we would be of the same mind and the same love, united in heart, thinking one thing. Because unless we unite our hearts, yes, how do you expect me to sacrifice and give myself to you? Right? Because if I'm not thinking about you and you're not thinking about me, then I'm just thinking about my own needs and my unwillingness then to give of myself again, to sacrifice. And when we are able to do this, my dear brothers and sisters, when we are able to humble ourselves and to serve each other, what happens? Well, again, we go back to St. Paul's words. Because of this, God greatly exalted him, exalted Jesus, and bestowed on him the name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bend, of those in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. When we are able to humble ourselves and to give ourselves in servitude to God, he raises us up. Because when we do that, we give him glory. And when we give him glory, he then glorifies us. So practically speaking, what does that mean for us then, right? Well, a real example that many of us probably can understand is that when we work for an employer, we sign a contract with them. In turn for my service to you, I'm going to be compensated for my work. And so, when we understand that there's a contract is involved with an employee and their employer, it can be looked at as a form of servitude. I'm your servant. I've come to serve you because you are going to compensate me. And so whenever we hear St. Paul speak of being a servant or a slave, that's the image that he wants us to have. It's not one of oppression, but one of contract, saying that I am willing to give this to you in return for something in return. And so when we work for our employer and he sees that we do the work that we have agreed to do, and especially when we go over and beyond what we are expected, what typically happens? Well, they recognize that you are a faithful worker and that you're helping their company to look good. And then they also realize, this is someone I can trust. And then they typically give more responsibilities and duties to you. And possibly through that, a promotion. Because you are giving my company, me, glory, I in turn glorify you by raising you up in status. And so the same thing is true with what our Lord has given to us when we give of ourselves to him. All the work that we do does not go unnoticed. And when we glorify him, he will glorify us. And that's why we have so many brothers and sisters, saints, that we honor. For that fact, their names will never be forgotten because of the life that they have given to God. And this is what St. Paul is encouraging from each and every one of us, my dear brothers and sisters, to be of that one mind and one heart, to have that same attitude that is also in Christ Jesus. What a beautiful thing, right? When we listen and are able to break up this passage from St. Paul as he teaches us how to live our lives in this world by imitating Jesus. Because in doing so, we begin to transform ourselves. We learned how to give of ourselves for others, for God. And in doing so, we learn what love truly is. And then we, as I tried to share last week, are able to get out of that mindset of being in a rat race, just trying to live for myself, and now learning to live for others. And it's a very beautiful thing, again. And our Lord gives us these people, like St. Paul, and his own words to us, like we hear in the gospel, to remind us always that he is a patient and merciful God. That even when we might say no, he allows us time to change our hearts to turn back to him, like that first son does in that parable. And when we say yes and still do nothing, he still waits, because nothing more than he desires than for a conversion of hearts from us. Never giving up on us, but continuing to try to give to us the blessing and graces that we need to become successful in this life so that we can get to heaven. And so, my dear brothers and sisters, one other thing that I want to share is that in this month of October, this is traditionally our month of stewardship, a call to renew our life of stewardship. And what does the word stewardship mean? But to be responsible for the gifts that our Lord has given to us and to give it back to him. And so I want to encourage and ask you to take time to pray about what you have done this past year and how you can challenge yourself to do a little more. And I'm not just asking for you to do this, I'm doing it myself too, right? Because every moment in our life, every day in our life, we're given an opportunity to become better, to be greater, like the saints who shed their blood for Christ, like St. Paul. And so, in this past year, how has your prayer life been? How has your prayer life been? Okay, so-so, pretty good, great. Now, how can you challenge yourself to do a little more? And then, how has your participation in our parish life been? All right, I know that in all of our lives, we have certain duties and responsibilities that are different from one another, that's different from me. But yet, in my busyness of my day-to-day life, how can I continue to give a little more to our parish family here to help build up our Lord's kingdom here at Presentation of Mary by service, by giving of my talent? And lastly, I know that it has been a challenging time for each and every one of us through these last few years since the pandemic with inflation and everything, but yet, Lord, you continue to bless us by giving us a home and shelter. And so in the midst of all these blessings and challenges, Lord, how can I give a little more so that I can continue to support the mission of our parish here to serve our people and to serve those in our community? All right, this is what our Lord is calling each and every one of us to, as St. Paul shares in his beautiful letter, to give of ourselves for love for God and for one another. And every moment in our lives, again, my dear brothers and sisters, we are challenged with the task of how can I give a little more, knowing that my Lord will never abandon me. A beautiful task, a beautiful love that God has for us, that he would entrust us with these things, that our brother St. Paul would continue to encourage us and remind us to live as saints for God's kingdom. And so my prayer, my dear brothers and sisters, is that we will be able to imitate not just Christ, but our brothers and sisters who have led the way for us to receiving the gift of faith that we have today, so that we will continue to be able to give of ourselves for love for God and for neighbor, for the sake of building up his kingdom. Coming together as a family, let us profess our one faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Because we know how much our Heavenly Father loves us and desires us to come to him as his beloved children, we bring to him now these petitions.
For the shepherds of the church, for the Pope, bishops, and priests, that their faith-filled teaching and preaching will lead all God's people into the one sheepfold of grace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who hold public office will imitate the goodness of God, who secures justice and rights of all oppressed, and that during the Respect Life Month, we will work fervently to advance the gospel of life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That God will bless our parish, strengthen our faith, and grant us the spirit of Christian stewardship so that we may give generously of our time in prayer, participation in ministry, and financial giving. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the grace this week to have a greater faith in the Lord and his providence, and a readiness to do his will, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the homebound and shut in, that they may be drawn deeper into the light that is Jesus, with an increase of peace, hope, and joy. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those suffering from addiction, mental illness, disease, and other ailments, that Christ will bring them the peace and healing they long for. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have been called to the banquet of eternal life, and for those who grieve for them, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the people of Presentation, for whom this Mass is offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, hear these prayers and petitions, spoken and unspoken, the signs of our hearts, as we make them through your Son's most holy name, our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
Lord, accept the sacrifice at your hands.
For the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all of this holy church.
Grant us, O merciful God, that this our offering may find acceptance with you, and that through it the wellspring of all blessing may be laid open before us, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you laid the foundations of the world and have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed man in your own image and set humanity over the whole world in all its wonder, to rule in your name over all you have made, and forever praise you in your mighty works, through Christ our Lord. And so with all the angels we praise you,
as in joyful celebration we acclaim. To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, Bernard, our Bishop, Michael and Joseph, his auxiliaries, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants, and all gathered here, whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you the sacrifice of praise, or they offer for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers in all things we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world. Save us, Savior of the world. For by your cross and resurrection.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty, from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with a sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, who though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen, 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 amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
See you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Remember your word to your servant, O Lord, by which you have given me hope. This is my comfort when I am brought low. Blessed are those whose way is blameless, who walk in the law of the Lord. Blessed are those who keep his decrees. With all their hearts they seek him. They never do anything evil, but walk in his ways. I will keep your statutes. Do not ever forsake me. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Remember your word to your servant, O Lord, by which you have given me hope. This is my comfort when I am brought sky. I have heard my people cry, all who dwell in dark and sin, my hand will save. I who made the stars of night, I will make their darkness bright.
I have heard you call.
Let us pray. May this heavenly mystery, O Lord, restore us in mind and body, that we may be co-heirs in glory with Christ, to whose suffering we are united whenever we proclaim his death, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
So my dear brothers and sisters, our faith formation program begins today, and we'll start here in the church, for those of you who are here for that, and then we'll move from the parish center from afterwards. So about 10:45, we'll start here in the church. And then on Monday, October 16th, is our RCIA or OCIA program for those who are looking to become Catholic or who wants to learn more about our Catholic faith. As I mentioned at the end of my homily, this month is our stewardship month, and so later this week, you should be receiving some materials for you to take and pray with about how God might be calling you to continue to grow in your stewardship for all of us, so that we can continue to build up our Lord's mission here at Presentation of Mary. Also this week, our Synod Small Group Leader sessions are begin on Wednesday, and so if you're still thinking about being a part of that, again, please register so we know how many or will be a part of our leadership training. Next Saturday will be October 7th after the 9 a.m. Mass at 10 a.m. outside the Kennard Street entrance. We'll be doing our blessing of animals in honor of St. Francis of Assisi. So all are welcome to bring their pets. And if you want, you can bring your children too. Maybe they might need some blessings, and so feel free to bring them as we continue to give God thanks for the gifts that he gives to us and his creatures, who continue to be companions for us in our world. Please, next Sunday is also our Panther Golf Classic tournament, which was delayed due to the bountiful rain that we received a week ago. And as you saw this past week, we continue to receive some of that bounty. And so please pray that next Sunday will at least be a beautiful day so that we can be able to have this tournament. And if you want to come out and swing a little, please come and do so. Or if you just want to come hang out with me, which I know many of you want to, feel free to do so as well. And lastly, if you see Deacon Mike Powers, please congratulate him and Marge as he celebrated 22 years as a deacon this past Friday on this feast of the Archangels Michael, Gabriel, and Raphael, and thank them for their service here at Presentation of Mary for these last 7-8 years, but also for their service to the church and love for Christ. So have a blessed and wonderful day. Enjoy God's gift of life that he has given to each and every one of us. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God. For our closing song, we'll sing verses 1 and 4.